Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about one of the best practices I mentioned in my previous video, using parameters for my data source connection. That's what I'm going to discuss. If you still not understand what I'm saying, if you have watched my previous video, which I mentioned the list of best practices, one of the best practices is like parameterize the connection. So here you can create different parameters for your server and databases, then you can use it. Once you use this parameters, what are the advantages you are going to get? That's what I'm going to demonstrate as part of this video. Without further delay, let's jump into today's topic. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So we are in Power BI now. So this report doesn't have any parameters. You can see no parameters at all. So right now I'm going to Power Query and check how this connections has been made for each table. So basically I built from my local computer. That's why I put my server as dot the sql.databases server name. And this is the actual database name. Okay, so this is how this works. So these two are hard coded here. That is AdventureWorks. Forget about these names. These are the variables that uses by the Power Query. And dot is the server name, and this is my database name. So this is the two things that takes as the parameter, and more all other tables uses the same thing. You can see here, even the dim currency, that first two lines are same. So we need to change this dynamically from outside. Okay, that is why we need the parameters. So how we can use it, I'm going to demonstrate in a couple of minutes. Before that, I will tell you what are the issues you can try to solve, or once you have these parameters, what is the advantages you're going to get. So this is the workspace and the data set properties. You can see here, there is no parameters here. One of the drawback over here is if you hard coded it, you can see this cannot be changed at the service level. You can see the server and database are fixed. You cannot have option for you to change your connections, right? So you need to download the file. If it is a very big file, for changing the connection, you need to download, or you are maintaining in some source version. You need to update your connections in the your local file, then publish it. It takes long time, or half an hour or 1 hour if it's very big file, right? But if you have parameters, it's a matter of just giving the connections here, then you can change the settings, then you can process it. Basically these scenarios will come like when you develop your report in development environment and you want to move it in different environments like UAT or staging. At that time people wants to test it in UAT, but you don't have any UAT environment, just you need to change the connections. Those kind of, there are a lot of use cases for it, but when you, while designing it, you start with creating a parameters, then it will be easy for you. So with this note, let's try to add parameters here. I'm going back to the Power Query, the Power BI desktop file, then just go to manage parameters or new parameter. So first things first, I need actually the server name. You can put server name, and it, the type is going to be a text, and I can get my server name over here. So this is my server name. So this is considered as a UAT or development server, and you can dynamically change when you want to change it to production or staging, whatever. So this is my server name. I have created one parameter, and I'm going to create another parameter. This is going to be my DB name, which is nothing but database name, and I can choose my type, and my database is going to be this one. Just use the name of that DB. There you go, that's it. So once you have this, then changing this itself not enough. You need to use, I mean, all these tables should use this particular parameters, right? For that, no need to think for each table I need to change manually, right? You might think like, okay, Once you have the parameter, I need to place the server name parameter here and the database name here. And assume you have 50 tables. You need to repeat 50 times, right? No need to do such a things. Once you created a parameter, just go to data source settings. Just click on this, change source. Then here you have option called parameters. So by default, I mean, it comes first, but if you have many parameters, you need to choose properly. So you can choose parameter. See, the whatever in the first, it will prompt you. I mean, it is appearing. You need to choose carefully. So basically this connection, SQL Server database connection, takes only two parameters, that is server and database, for that we created. Okay. Just choose this one. That's it. Then close. So once you choose close, then you can do refresh once so that it will be authenticated, or maybe if you choose different servers, it will prompt you for authentication. Since it is already the same server, it is not asking me for authenticate. So this is fine. Now once you choose this one, then you can have ability to choose or change this server as well as the database name. Okay, this is how you can able to parameterize your Power BI files. So it is connected, this is being loaded. Now you can see either you can change parameters here. Now you want to test it for another server, another database, you just change it here and just press OK. You can get the updated details. So let me publish this to Power BI services. And even over there, you can choose to change the parameters. So this is very good feature, and I would surely say everyone should implement as part of their project management or the Power BI development lifecycle. So let's refresh this page. There you go. So here I got the parameters. Right now I can able to choose, let's say in some other server you have something like staging here, you choose here and you change your DB name, then you can press apply and then refresh your database. It will read the data from there, so no need to, you can download your file or hover it will be reduced. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.